In today's video, we're going to focus on how to make an EGR cooler yourself. You'd probably ask why? From information in various videos on YouTube and other forums, I learned that you can get the best results with combining a couple of coolers from a car together. This combination doesn't really sit right with me, so I am going to try and do it myself. Here's a little drawn-in plan on how I want to make it. Let's get started. To make the case, I will use old pieces of stainless sheet metal and a 12mm installation pipe. After a while of thinking and doing the math, the cooler will have 12 pass-through pipes. That will be enough for sure, and there will be a big exhaust flow reserve. I am going to montage the breather as high as it's possible. It's time to check the tightness. I will start the test on about 2 bars pressure, and then on a bit higher one, on about 8 bars. The only leakouts started on the threaded connection on a high pressure. At the outlet of the cooler, I will weld a much larger diameter pipe so that the exhaust gases do not have any blowout resistance, and with a drop to the condensate. On the inlet, I will weld a tube previously rolled under the cone. After pushing it in, it fits perfectly, and it holds on very tightly. Thank you. On the exit, I montaged a net filter with a ball valve. It will serve as a regulator of liquid flow. On the liquid return, I installed a flow sensor. It will inform me if the pump works. If you liked the video, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel.